Sir, first of all, I would like to compliment and acknowledge the issue brought out by Honorable Member B.K. Hari Prasad Ji. He has brought this Constitutional Amendment Bill under Private Member Bill for inclusion of Kodava and Tulu language under the 8th schedule of the Constitution of India. Many honorable members have already put forward their views and echoed the sentiment of their communities in this August House. I must tell you, sir, that we also share those sentiments and those viewpoints which all the honorable members have raised in this August House. So this is a very sensitive issue as well as full of emotions, sentiments, which reflects the identity, the culture, the heritage of various communities of this country. From time to time, various groups have been coming to Home Ministry and put forward the demand. As you know, sir, we have presently 22 languages under the 6th schedule to the Constitution of India. 22 languages. And we have formally listed 38 languages which have come in form of demands to be included in the 6th schedule to the Constitution of India. Besides these 38 languages, there are many more dialects, many more spoken languages informally keep coming to the Home Ministry for their inclusion. Sir, just to make my point clear, I want to bring forward before the House what the Home Ministry had recently replied to one of the special mentions made in this August House, in the other August House, in the Lok Sabha. Sir, as dialect and languages, it's very difficult to differentiate between dialect and language. Even in various forms of demands for inclusion as a language under 8th schedule, many of the languages are using same script as what we call Nagri. So what should be the criteria? Language is a social, cultural, geographical construct which takes its shape after having a long journey, and then it gets a recognition. Now, I would like to appeal the August House to understand the position of the government. It is not easy to define the criteria for objectives, how to make those provisions which will make a particular language or a dialect qualified to be included in the 8th schedule to the Constitution of India. It is such a complicated thing. That is why, whether it's a PAHWA committee set up in 1996 or the Mahapatra committee set up in 2003, both the committee reports, which we have gone through in detail, could not conclusively come and form a kind of criteria which should be adopted as a means in deciding which are the languages and what should be the criteria for deciding those languages to be included in the 8th schedule to the Constitution of India. It has been a political decision from before, but now, since this demand has come through a private member regulation, And many honourable members have put forward their pending cases while participating in the debate and supporting the resolution moved by Honourable Member B.K. Hari Prasad ji. Various members have put forward their cases, which have come to the Home Ministry, and we are in the knowledge of all the demands and backgrounds and the cases being made in respective demand. Sir, let me point out one important regulation of the Parliament. There were two cases. One was related to the official language, which Hindi has been recognized as an official language. And there is another regulation passed in 1968. And that regulation speaks about forming certain criteria and asking the UPSC to decide what are the criteria to be adopted while conducting the examinations for All India Civil Service and the elite services. So when this report, the UPSC sent a report, and they were almost ready with the recommendation, then many of the members of parliament had raised objections. So that also, the recommendations made by the UPSC also is kept in abeyance. Sir, regarding the original mover of this private member bill by B.K. Hari Prasad ji, I also would like to make a mention in this august house about those some of the important personalities who have contributed to the growth, to the greatness of this country, particularly two persons who belong to Kodava language group from the Kodagu region, the Field Marshal Kariappa and General Thimaya, which Hari Prasad ji had mentioned while he was addressing and initiating this discussion. We can't forget, the nation cannot forget those important souls. They have given so much of contribution to this nation. Besides that, all other languages or dialects which have come in forms of demand also have their rich heritage and their rich history, which we have to admit that we can't ignore the importance of each language which are in the list of the 38 which are pending in the Home Ministry. Sir, both the Pahua Committee of 1996 and the Sitapan Mahapatra Committee of 2003, since they could not come into conclusive kind of criteria required and objective set up by the government, the Home Ministry had set up one internal committee headed by an additional secretary rank officer to re-look again both this committee recommendation as well as the various cases which are pending. So the committee had looked through, and the committee has representatives from various ministries like Ministry of Human Resource Development, Ministry of Information and Broadcasting, the Central Institute of Official Indian Languages, Mysore, and the Sahitya Academies. So the committee which Home Ministry constituted is actively looking after the concerns which were raised by the honourable members while taking part in this discussion. Sir, besides that, I would like to make two, three important points. During the discussion, some of the honourable members have raised about imposition of one language over the other language. Being the minister in charge of the official language, that is the Hindi, when we assume the the position of this government, we have made it clear that there is no question of imposition of Hindi over any of the regional languages. All Indian languages are equally important, but it is because of the decision of the joint decision of the both the houses of this parliament, Hindi was made an official language as a link. English continues to be the colloquial language or the official language or the working language. It will continue. Hindi has been made as an official language, considering the spirit of all the members of the parliament who took part in the regulation which took place in this August House. Thereafter, there is no question of Hindi being imposed on any other region or over any other languages. In 2014, when we issued one circular, it was a repetitive of the circular which has been issued from time to time, that this is the spirit of the regulation of the parliament, and these are the rules framed under the various guidelines in the Ministry of Home Affairs. So Hindi has to be promoted. At the same time, all the Indian languages are to be promoted. And there are provisions under various ministries where regional languages are to be promoted. Regional languages means no language is more important than other languages. All Indian languages are equally important. It's just a constitutional status that 22 languages are included in the 8th schedule to the Constitution of India, and some other are not yet. But it doesn't mean that those who are not in the 8th schedule are less important. It's just a procedure. And sir, for the benefit of this August House, I would like to mention that we have a series of discussion in the ministry, and we have met most of the delegations who have come and demanded and putting forward the case of their respective languages. We have not given any kind of preference over one languages over other languages. It is under the active consideration of the Ministry of Home Affairs to ensure that justice must be done. But while justice is being done, we must ensure that there is no complications which will likely to arise in the future, because the subject matter is very sensitive. While we are appreciating the regulation moved by the Honourable Member Hari Prasad Ji, we also take into account the suggestions which have come from various members of the Parliament. Chairman Sahab, मैं आपको आज इस समय में बहुत ज्यादा वक्त नहीं लेते हुए इतना मैं कितना समय लेना है वो
मंत्री जी को बोलने दीजिए, दूसरा मंत्री क्यों बाधा डाल रहे हैं?
पार्लियामेंट्री अफेयर्स मंत्री के पास तो अधिकार है सर, क्योंकि
ठीक से स्पष्टीकरण नहीं हुआ।
कुछ कुछ भाषा जिसको बोलने वाला का संख्या बहुत बहुत कम है, और कुछ कुछ का भाषा उसके बोलने वाला का संख्या बहुत ज्यादा है, फिर भी हमने उसको गंभीरता से देखते हुए ये कभी नहीं कहा कि आपका भाषा बोलने वाला इतना कम है इसलिए आपका महत्व कम है, ऐसा सरकार ने कभी नहीं कहा। और हमने सबसे बात किया, जो ओरिजिनल सबसे पुराना डिमांड्स है उससे, और जो नए नए सूची में आए हैं उन लोग से भी सबसे हम लोग मिले, और डेलीगेशन मैंने खुद बहुत सारे डेलीगेशन से वार्ता किया है, और सबको यही कहा कि क्योंकि हमारे पास कोई सेट क्राइटेरिया नहीं है, हमारे पास कोई सेट गाइडलाइन नहीं है, और बहुत से मेंबर्स ने ये कहा कि आप गाइडलाइन क्यों नहीं बना सकते, और आज तक भारत सरकार ने प्रॉपर गाइडलाइन क्यों नहीं बनाया। इसी चीज को अध्यक्ष महोदय मैं यही कहना चाहता हूं कि भाषा ऐसा चीज है, अगर इसको मैं एक सीधा क्राइटेरिया बना दूं तो उसमें भी सवाल उठेगा। ये मामला ऐसा है, इसमें पूरा गाइडलाइन बना नहीं सकते। इसलिए 38 भाषा, इसमें से तो कुछ ऐसे है जिसका स्क्रिप्ट है जिसको आप लिख सकते हैं, कुछ भाषाएं ऐसे हैं जिसमें स्क्रिप्ट नहीं है। लेकिन जो आम तौर पर तो ये कहा जाता है कि डायलेक्ट जो होता है वो सिर्फ बोली है, उसका लिखित नहीं होते हैं, लिखित रूप में नहीं होता है। और कुछ भाषाएं ऐसे हैं जिसका लिखित रूप में उसका स्क्रिप्ट होते हैं। तो कुछ लोग कहते हैं कि जिसका स्क्रिप्ट है उसको हम लोग लैंग्वेज कहते हैं, भाषा, और जिसका स्क्रिप्ट नहीं है सिर्फ बोला जाता है उसको हम लोग डायलेक्ट कहते हैं। ये भी मैं नहीं कह रहा हूं सर, क्योंकि मैं ये कहूंगा तो फिर ये भी कंट्रोवर्सी हो जाएगा। इसलिए डायलेक्ट कौन है, लैंग्वेज कौन है, और कब भी डायलेक्ट को हम लैंग्वेज फॉर्म में लाते हैं, इसका भी विचार सबको मिलकर के करना होगा। एक मंत्रालय, एक सरकार अपने एक तरफा इसको लेकर के कोई मत देना भी संभव नहीं है। जो सेंटिमेंट्स काफी लोगों ने कहा उस दिन जब से चर्चा आरंभ हुआ, काफी हमारे सीनियर मेंबर्स ऑफ पार्लियामेंट ने इसको चर्चा में भाग लेते हुए बहुत ही खूबसूरत अपना अपना जो एक्सपीरियंसेस है, अपना नॉलेज है, अपना जो आइडियाज है, उन शेयर किया। और आज भी काफी माननीय सदस्यगणों ने इस बात को सामने में रखा है। इसलिए एक एक मेंबर्स को अगर हम जवाब देंगे, नोट्स तो बनाए हैं, एक एक मेंबर्स को जवाब देंगे तो फिर चर्चा बहुत लंबा हो जाएगा। लेकिन सामूहिक रूप से जितने मेंबर्स ने इस पे चर्चा में भाग लिया, सबका सेंटिमेंट और सबका भावनाओं को ध्यान में रखते हुए मैं ये कहना चाहता हूँ कि जो हमारे सरकार आने के बाद 2014 के बाद हमने जो एक समिति, इंटरनल मैकेनिज्म एक वर्कआउट किया है, जो पहावा कमेटी या महापत्रक कमेटी या उसके अलावा जो भी हमारे पास में अनुशंसाएं आए हैं, सजेशंस भी आए हैं, सबको एकजुट करके हम एक तरीका निकालने का, एक रास्ता ढूंढने का प्रयास कर रहे हैं। जैसे मैंने कहा अध्यक्ष महोदय कि क्राइटेरिया या गाइडलाइन बहुत मुश्किल चीज है, लेकिन रास्ता निकालना बहुत जरूरी है। और मांग बहुत जोर से मांग आया है कि इसका एक रास्ता निकालना चाहिए, तो रास्ता निकालने का हम लोग ढूंढ रहे हैं। और मैं विश्वास करता हूं कि हम लोग जल्द से जल्द कोई ना कोई तरीके से एक रास्ता निकलेंगे जिससे जो भाषाएं यहाँ पेंडिंग है, 38 भाषाएं हैं, उसका हम किस तरह से और किस प्रक्रिया से हम इसको 8वीं सूची में ला सकते हैं। आज जो रेजुलेशन बीके हरिप्रसाद जी ने लाए हैं, अगर हम उसी फॉर्म में पास करेंगे तो ये फिर सदन का जो भावना है ये भी उसको पूरा सम्मिलित नहीं करेंगे, क्योंकि इसमें आपने कोडवा और थुल्लू का भाषा का आपने जिक्र किया है इस प्राइवेट मेंबर रेजुलेशन। तो हम आइसोलेशन में इस बिल को अगर पास करेंगे तो फिर सदन का भावना हम पूरा उसको कदर नहीं कर पाएंगे। इसलिए मेरा हरिप्रसाद जी को मैं हाथ जोड़ करके मैं निवेदन करना चाहता हूं कि इस सेंटिमेंट से सब जुड़े हुए हैं, सरकार भी जुड़े हुए हैं, पूरा सदन जुड़े हुए हैं। आपको सबने धन्यवाद भी दिया है, आपने ये बिल मेहनत करके यहां लाए हैं और इसको विस्तृत रूप से चर्चा करने में आपने एक रास्ता दिखाया है, आपको धन्यवाद दे चुके हैं। और आप के भावना के साथ मैं सम्मिलित हूं और पूरा सदन सम्मिलित है, अपना अपना बात भी रखा है। पूरा चीज को सरकार को कुछ समय और चाहिए, और ये मत कहिए कि कितना और समय लेंगे, क्योंकि कितने सालों से ये चल रहा है और मैंने सारा चीज को एक शॉर्टकट में बताने का कोशिश किया। मैं समझता हूं कि जो सरकार के पास जो कठिनाई है और जो परिस्थिति है उसको जरूर बीके हरिप्रसाद जी समझेंगे। तो मैं माननीय सदस्य को मैं निवेदन करना चाहता हूं कि आप इस बिल को विड्रॉ कीजिए और सरकार को एक नई सिरे से पहल करने में आप सहायता कीजिए। यही अनुरोध करते हुए मैं आपके माध्यम से बीके हरिप्रसाद जी को धन्यवाद देते हुए प्रस्ताव इस प्राइवेट मेंबर विधायक को विड्रॉ करने का मैं अपील करता हूँ।